Hello everyone, and welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel, if you're brand new, but if you're a regular, welcome back. So guys, today's video, another video. I'm going to be doing it on Spark Mail today, and Sanebox, giving you a short outline of how I use it on a daily basis as my email manager. Now what I'll be doing today is demonstrating Spark on Mac, although it does work very well on iOS 2, and I'll be explaining my sort of experience with email application 2 at the moment. A lot of people asking, how do we navigate this whole personal email third-party thing at the moment? What's the best app? I will be doing more videos on this, but I wanted to give you my sort of thoughts on how I'm using it. Maybe it will reflect on your own situation. I wanted to outline some of the features of Spark, that's quite interesting, and also show you how Sanebox sort of plays into that. Which I've been using for 2 months. So I'm quite excited for this feature. I'm ready and raring to go, Don't know what this is the other way around. I've got my Thomas Frank, I don't know when anyone can see it. I bought a t-shirt from the Thomas Frank YouTube merchandise. He does awesome videos, Thomas Frank. And I will be getting him on the podcast soon. So stay tuned. He will be talking about his own Notion layout. I'm proper excited about it. I don't know about anyone else, but it would be awesome because I followed him for ages. Anyway, enough about that. Let's dive into Spark. As you can see, this is my Spark. This is the dark mode for Mojave and macOS. Now, one thing that I particularly like about Spark is the design. I think that when I was looking at email alternatives after Newton, obviously I had a great application with Newton. I was very happy, and then overnight sort of went down. I looked at two main applications after I left, and that was mainly from a lot of my research at Newton. We always kept an eye on competitors, naturally, like you do, and I was always aware of them. I looked at Spark and Polymail. Now, Polymail is more designed for a team-orientated email application, whereas Spark was more of a personal application, and I knew that it was a company that I previously was aware of in terms of trusted and was happy with, Readl. Now, Readl develop a whole host of applications. You might know some of them, likes of Documents, Spark, Calendars 5, and a couple more PDF applications too. They've got a whole suite of applications. I liked the fact that they did Spark and they did it for free. So I was happy to jump on board. But actually, I was happy to pay for an email application, if I'm honest. And I'll come to that nearer the end. So I got on Spark. I did dual try it with Polymail. A lot of people pressured me to go towards Astro 2. Didn't get enough time to try that before it got shut down. Actually quite good for me being a reviewer because it saved me a lot of time. But Spark really did stand out. And the main reasons I was happy with Spark is, again, design was fantastic. On Mac, I really loved the fact that you could have multiple accounts, the fact that you could go on the calendar function as well. Imports the calendars that you have connected to your email accounts, which is great because I use a lot of Google Calendar. So if I'm like in a rush and I can see all of the details of my events and even move them about and things like that, that was very handy. Of course, you had the ability to, if you wanted to, use the team functions. They do have teams functions in Spark. So if I wanted to at any given point in the future, I could use the shared elements of that. But the one thing I liked is the favorites down the left-hand side. So I have, this is Sanebox. I don't know whether it's Sanebox or Sanebox, but Sanebox is the way I'm gonna say it. I've been calling that in my head for a while. Now, I actually got Sanebox probably the week after Newton came out, because I knew that when Newton announced a shutdown, Sanebox obviously was essentially a replacement for my low priority inbox inside of Newton. So there was a feature inside of Newton that would essentially allow you to get newsletters, social media messages filtered into that box, and it basically cleaned out my email, the majority of it. I knew that Spark sort of had that with Smart Inbox, but I don't really like the Smart Inbox idea. I think it's the way it's visually laid out in Spark. And I wanted to keep that simple, but still have Sanebox there. So Sanebox is something I use. What it does now is it collects up all of my social media messages, team communication apps, newsletters, pretty much everything you can think of. Activity logs, you know, all of the stuff that you'd expect. So let me just demonstrate. I've got like Twist up here, notification from Twist. I collected a point at the local coffee shop I got, and Amazon order that's arriving today. Hopefully the buzzer won't go during this demonstration. Discounts for Prezzo, which is like a restaurant that's around the UK, and so many more. Receipt Bank, you know, Google Analytics. So it's almost filtering out all the stuff, and that's inside a box or a folder inside of Gmail. I've only got it connected to one email at the moment. That's my Gmail, my main Gmail. And that basically filters that out in something called Sane Later. So then, like, low priority ones that you can really focus on later. And Sane News. Essentially, Sane News is all of your newsletters or discounts, really. The majority of them are, unless you train them to go into the other inboxes. Now, this is what's quite exciting about Sanebox, and I will be doing more in-depth reviews about it in the future, a separate review on it, but this is more of an overview. It's very smart. So once you start putting stuff into the inboxes, certain inboxes, it just starts to learn about what your routine is, and then it will start putting them in there for future. So you constantly move it, it'll constantly react, which is fantastic. That's something you want with an email management tool. Again, I haven't tried too many of them. That's something I'd say. I've only tried the likes of Sanebox, and that was a recommendation from Paul Miners from ages ago, and Tim Ferriss, I think, because it was from one of his books. I've also got Sane No Replies, which is an area that essentially brings up all emails that I don't have a reply to yet, but I've sent. So it's almost like a waiting box. Great way to view all of those. So as you can imagine, it's actually reduced the amount of email that's coming into the inbox, which is awesome because I love that, because it's really reducing. It's only bringing in the main emails, and if I get an email that I don't like, I just move it to one of these. It will learn for future. Now, talking about some of the features of Spark that I really, really like, is there's probably two core features that I love, and that is Snooze. So Snooze is swipeable as well inside of the Mac app, as well as on the iPhone. So I can swipe to Snooze, and it will bring up a host of options. I quite like this window. It says later today, tomorrow, next week, someday, or you can pick a date exactly, which is really, really nice. You can put an alert on it too. Now, the other one I really like is the send later. So if I press new email, I go down to this one, I can obviously send it later. I could also get a follow-up reminder too, which is something I actually haven't used yet, hence the prompt there. But again, it's something that I find really useful. But I really love the one, the send later. All of them are stored in the Outbooks. It just is a great way to visualize it. So I have been using Spark since probably Newton shut down. That's not from last week, when Newton announced their shutdown. It's mainly because obviously Newton was unavailable and I just wanted to start getting used to the application. I will say this, I am probably not fully committed yet to Spark. I do want to try other applications. Missive is another application that I've reviewed here on the channel, but I am very impressed with. It's a Mac, iOS, Android, and Windows application, a very cross-platform experience. But do remember, this one is a paid application, which sort of sucks. I'm just going to have a little bit of water, which sort of sucks because you've got an application that is limited. You've got an application, obviously with Spark, you can sort of go to town, but with Missive, you're definitely going to be paying unless you only use it for sending. So guys, that is my email setup. I hope it was useful. Let me know in the comments what your email setup is. Again, one thing I didn't mention, I will be reviewing Superhuman very, very soon. So do stay tuned for that one. I will be giving a full review on that and some of my thoughts. It's gorgeous from the previews, but again, I want to see it in a working condition. Anyway, guys, a big thank you for stopping by today. Let me know if you want more videos like this. Again, this is my sort of setup. It's going to take time to learn about what the best third-party email application is out there, and that space is continually growing. Anyway, guys, a big thanks for stopping by today. Make sure to check out the Skillshare option below. There's loads of courses you can enjoy. But without further ado, guys, make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon.